Placental abruption is a serious pregnancy complication that many women don't hear about until it happens to them. It can be scary, but knowing the signs, causes, and treatments can make all the difference. In today's video, we'll break down everything you need to know about placental abruption: what it is, how to recognize it, and what doctors do to keep both mom and baby safe. Let's get started. Placental abruption happens when the placenta partially or completely separates from the uterus before birth. Since the placenta is what delivers oxygen and nutrients to your baby, this can be a very dangerous situation. This condition affects about 1 in 100 pregnancies, but it can range from mild to severe. The most important thing is recognizing the symptoms early and getting medical attention fast. Doctors don't always know why placental abruption happens, but some factors can increase the risk. These include high blood pressure, like preeclampsia or chronic hypertension, abdominal trauma, such as a car accident or a fall, smoking or drug use, especially cocaine, which affects blood flow, previous placental abruption, which means a higher risk if you've had it before, carrying multiples, like twins or triplets, premature rupture of membranes, meaning your water breaks too early, blood clotting disorders. While some of these risk factors can't be controlled, avoiding smoking, managing blood pressure, and getting regular prenatal care can help lower your risk. So how do you know if you have placental abruption? The key signs to watch for are vaginal bleeding. This may be light or heavy, and sometimes there's no bleeding at all if the blood is trapped inside. Severe abdominal or back pain. Unlike contractions, this pain doesn't go away. Uterine tenderness or tightness. Your belly might feel hard or rigid. Decreased fetal movement. If your baby isn't moving as much, it could mean reduced oxygen supply. If you have any of these symptoms, don't wait. Call your doctor or go to the hospital immediately. Time is critical when it comes to placental abruption. Doctors diagnose placental abruption based on your symptoms, an ultrasound, and fetal monitoring to check your baby's heart rate. However, ultrasounds don't always catch every case, so doctors rely heavily on physical exams and symptoms. What happens if you have placental abruption? In mild cases, bed rest and monitoring are usually recommended if the abruption is small and the baby is stable. For moderate to severe cases, emergency delivery might be necessary, especially if the baby is in distress or if there's heavy bleeding, and this usually means a C-section. Blood transfusions may be needed if there's significant blood loss. Medications can help manage contractions or delay labor if it's early. In severe cases, placental abruption can lead to preterm birth, low oxygen levels for the baby, and serious complications for the mother, including heavy bleeding. That's why early detection is so important. Unfortunately, there's no guaranteed way to prevent placental abruption, but you can lower your risk by managing high blood pressure. Work with your doctor to keep it under control. Avoid smoking, alcohol, and drugs, as these can increase the risk. Protect your belly by wearing a seatbelt properly and being cautious to avoid falls or trauma. Attend all prenatal checkups because regular monitoring helps catch any issues early. If you've had a placental abruption in a previous pregnancy, talk to your doctor about extra monitoring for your next pregnancy. If you experience any of the following, get medical help right away. Heavy vaginal bleeding, severe constant belly or back pain, if your baby's movements slow down or stop, or contractions that don't go away. These are all signs of a possible medical emergency, and getting help quickly can save both you and your baby. Placental abruption is serious, but knowing the signs and getting medical attention early can make a huge difference. If you're currently pregnant or know someone who is, share this video so more moms can stay informed. If you found this video helpful, hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications for more pregnancy-related content. And if you have any questions or experiences with placental abruption, drop a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.